It takes some doing to kill someone with a box cutter. To think that he never even cut the bread. He said it made his wrist hurt. He claimed he had carpal tunnel syndrome. That one they say the pain is excruciating whenever you try to hold anything. And yet, when he slashed the kids' throats, he somehow found an unprecedented strength inside of him. He did it to punish me. He said I was his slave, and I had no right to go live alone with his kids, let alone the fact that they were mine also. It takes a lot of strength to kill someone with a box cutter, and he must have given up when he tried to cut his own throat. He survived. I guess his skin was as thick as a crocodile. Yet he never shed a tear. He said the job had to be done, period. Like fixing a leaky pipe or oiling a gate that won't shut properly. You do what you have to do and things get back on track, nice and tidy, the way they've always been and the way they should be. No exceptions. Me, he never even touched. I'm still alive. Or so everyone thinks. But since that day, even though you might see me walking around, smoking cigarettes, I'm as good as dead.